A stream of refrigerant 134A at 1.2 MPa and 16 degrees Celsius is mixed with another stream at 1.2 MPa and 90 degrees Celsius. If the mass flow rate of the cold stream is twice that of the hot one, what is the temperature and the quality of the exit stream? As usual, pause here and try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the third example for the heat exchangers and mixing chambers main lecture. The link to that 9-minute lecture and all the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. The mass balance tells us that what's coming out is the same as what's coming in. And this, in combination with our energy conservation expression and the information about the stream mass flows coming in, tells us that we can find H3 in terms of H2 and H1. This H3 value is important because with it we can determine the temperature and the phase of our exit stream. For inlet 1, we go to our saturated tables by temperature and notice that for 16 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure is 504 kilopascals. Since our pressure is 1.2 MPa, inlet 1 is a compressed liquid and we can take HF at 16 degrees Celsius as our H1 value. For inlet 2, we see that for 90 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure is over 3000, and since our pressure at 2 is 1.2 MPa, we can conclude that inlet 2 is at a superheated state. We go to our superheated tables, look up 1.2 MPa and 90 degrees Celsius, and write down the specific enthalpy value for H2. We substitute these two values in our H3 expression and find the specific enthalpy at the exit. With this value and a pressure of 1.2 MPa at the exit, we see that HF is lower than that and HG is higher than that. This means that the refrigerant is in fact in a saturated mixture state and that the temperature is the saturation temperature at 46.29 degrees Celsius. As for the quality, we use the expression we derived for it in the quality 9-minute lecture, link below, and find it to be 24.8%. And that fully describes our state at the exit. If you want to check out other examples in the heat exchangers and mixing chambers topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermo course as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!